lens. Oh, you filmed, you just press. Today, we're gonna make the best pancakes that you probably ever tasted. And it just so happens that they are vegan. And all you need is three ingredients. So all you're gonna need in the cupboard is all-purpose flour, some soya milk or oat milk, something like that, and flaxseed, which is made by the flax egg, which means you put in 1 tablespoon of flaxseed, 3 tablespoons of hot water. We double it for 2 of us, as you'll see. So we use 2 tablespoons of flaxseed, 6 tablespoons of hot water. I use that out of the tap, it's fine. 2 cups of milk and 2 cups of flour, and that's exactly it. And the best bit about it is you can keep all these things in the cupboard and they won't go off like eggs or anything anyway. And it's, you know, unless you've kept chickens yourself and they're roaming around dropping eggs, it's probably not good to support the egg industry. They can also be thin enough so that they can be like crepes. When I put them in and I move them around, because we found that they get a bit thick in the middle if you don't do that. And actually I'm using a wok as well, but you can use any pan you want. So let's go and make probably what you've probably tasted is the best pancakes ever. First off, we need 2 tablespoons of hot water. No, 6 tablespoons of hot water. We use hot water out of the tap and it's fine. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is where I got told I should have probably dried the spoon first and used it. And you want 2 flaxseed. 1, 2. Let me just get this one down here. Stir it in. Now 2 cups of flour, which means 1 cup is usually good enough. Come on, you bugger. If you run out of flour, you can use a bit of self-raising flour because it only raises when it's in the oven, so I'm told. So this is where it all pours out, isn't it? Two of flour. Right, I've just been told I meant to sieve it. So now I'm gonna sieve it into the bowl. So yeah, that's how you make more mess. So sieve it into the bowl. I don't know what difference it makes if you don't sieve it, but I'm told I have to sieve it. Right, 2 cups of milk. One, 2, and then add the flaxseed, which has gone all clumpy and hard. Add that in, then stir it up. And the reason I use this is for less dishes. You'll have to excuse the sound of the washing machine. Some idiot, me, put it on when I'm doing something to make a video. Right, so this is what it looks like. And if it's not runny enough, you can just add some more water, a little bit of water to this, and make it more runny, because you want it runny when it drops into the pan. Okay, I use a flat spatula for this because it's easier, and I actually use less heat because I'm using a wok, and I don't put too much, I'll just spoil it. I don't put too much oil in there. One and a half to two of these, and as you saw, I moved it around to make it flatter, and then we just let it set a bit before I flip it, stick it on the ceiling. Sometimes I test the edges. Because if you don't have enough oil, it will stick and start to burn. And if it does that, you want to just make sure that you get the edges up quick. It's just starting to do that there. Usually what you can do is go like that, get it. Don't try and move it when you flip it, else it'll stick again and you'll wreck it. So you just want to wait until it starts setting. Once it starts setting hard, it'll start moving. There you go. There you go, sit. Then it moves. As they say, the first one's always a mess, right? So that's it, one on the plate. Actually, there's a fun smiley face.